with my talks. One quick check with all of you. Are you all comfortable with English as a language of communication?
Yes, sir.
I came to Gujarat in the year 2000. Most of you were not even born. Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
You were born?
No.
Which year are you born?
2005.
3, 4, 5. So I came to Gujarat in the year 2000 and I knew nothing of Gujarati. How many of you know Gujarati? Wow, everyone knows Gujarati. I'm so happy. Except my dear friend. You don't know Gujarati?
I can read and write, but I can't speak.
No, not you. The person that reads. But you understand Gujarati, right? I knew nothing of Gujarati that time. And I was invited by a principal in a school to talk to students. So I went to the school, I started talking. For 30 minutes non-stop I spoke in English. And after 30 minutes, there was a boy sitting in a corner. I asked him some question. I said, yes, my dear friend. So don't forget, I knew nothing of Gujarati that time. So he stood up from his chair and he kicked off. He said, Sahib, don't forget, I knew nothing of Gujarati that time. So he told me, Sahib, Angrezi apnu avadtu nathi. Hindi apna gamtu nathi. Gujarati avade. Jatse. He couldn't understand anything. Everything went above the head like bonkers. But मुझे टेंशन इसलिए नहीं था कि जो उसने कहा वो मुझे समझ नहीं आया. मेरा टेंशन ये था कि वो बेचारा बच्चा पिछले आधे घंटे से मेरा टॉर्चर कैसे संभाल रहा है. डोंट अंडरस्टैंड समथिंग एंड समबडी इज जस्ट थ्रोइंग थिंग्स ऑन यू, इट्स अ टॉर्चर. सो नाउ आई ऑलवेज मेक श्योर, कभी भी मैं जाके बच्चों से बात करता हूँ तो फर्स्ट आई ऑलवेज चेक, are you all comfortable with English?
Yes.
Or you want me to take the session mix in English and Hindi? Because I still can't speak Gujarati.
English is fine.
Yes, for all of you?
Yes, sir.
Great. I'm going to talk on something which we call as goal setting. And what I'm doing is, I'm primarily targeting grade 9. Because you are from grade 7, 8, 9, right? How many of you are from 7th? Wow. 8th? Great. And 9th? Perfect. Any class, whether it is 7th or 8th or 9th, always comes once in life. Yes, no?
Yes.
Is there anybody sitting in this forum who wants a class to come twice, thrice? Hai koi aisa? सर दो तीन बार तो आनी चाहिए ना, एक बार में क्या होगा? ऐसा तो कोई नहीं है. आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू वॉन्ट योर क्लास टू कम ओनली वंस एंड आई ऑल्सो विश एंड प्रे दैट एवरी क्लास शुड कम इन योर लाइफ ओनली वंस विद ऑनर. ऑनर समझ, इज्जत. इज्जत यू अंडरस्टैंड, कि वो इज्जत से आए और इज्जत से चली जाए. हाँ, कहीं वो अटक गई तो हैप्पी बर्थडे हो जाए. यस नो? हाँ. सो all of us encounter a particular class only once, and I wish and hope that all of you should encounter your class only once, right? Now when you come into senior classes, like 7th, 8th, 9th are relatively senior classes, hai na? Aap jo apne ghar mein chote younger brother, sister hain, ya you know, you see in your society smaller boys, girls, you have already started picking them. Yes, no? Don't forget. Huh? I know everything. Huh? So you don't need to tell me. Chote bache se, "Aa, tu chota hai, main bada hu." Ye already chalu ho gaya. So, jab aap senior classes mein aa jate ho, to aapko ek sawal bahut encounter karne ko milta hai. There are a lot of people who ask you one question. Can you tell me what is that question? What do you want to do? Beta, kya karo? Kahin pe bhi jao, beta, kya karo? किसी के घर जाओ, बेटा क्या करोगे? कभी कभी इतना गुस्सा आता है कि मैंने पूछा. Did I ask you? Why are you bloody poking your nose in my life? आता है ना कभी कभी गुस्सा, कभी कभी. लेकिन वो कभी कभी आना चाहिए, रोज नहीं आना चाहिए. What happens is, we were doing a research, I was doing a research with one of my friend at IIM Ahmedabad, trying to find out that why these elders, you know, ask this question to students. Or I call you as young adults. You're all young adults. You are exposed to the latest things in the world. You are exposed to technology. So whatever an adult is supposed to know, you already know it. And I am aware of it. So I call all of you as young adults. Right? So when you are young adults, the full adults come and ask you these sort of questions. So first we were trying and researching that who are the people who ask you such questions. We came with three species. Species?
Yes.
Three species of people who ask such questions. You want to know who are those?
Yes.
The first species is known as parents' friends. Do you agree? आप गलती से किसी पापा मम्मी के फ्रेंड के घर चले जाओ, वो पकड़ लेते हैं आपको, बेटा इधर मैं बताता हूँ तेरे को करके क्या होता है, मैं बताता हूँ आगे क्या करना चाहिए, है ना? इसको हम कहते हैं ज्ञान बांटना। You understand? उनको ज्ञान बांटने में बहुत मजा आता है। The second species of people who love to give you ज्ञान are known as friends parents. और गलती से किसी दोस्त के घर चले जाओ, उसके पिताजी थाम लेते, बोले आजा बेटा मैं बताता हूँ, ऐसे होता है आप सबके साथ। एंड द थर्ड मोस्ट वल्नरेबल सेट ऑफ पीपल हु क्रिएट अ लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंशिएशन इन डिसीजन मेकिंग एट योर हाउस आल्सो आर नोन एज रिलेटिव्स, होता है? और फिर कंपैरिजन चालू होता है घर में, है ना? मामा के बेटे को देख, चाचा की बेटी को देख, फुआ के बेटे को देख, मतलब एवरी टाइम यू आर आस्क्ड टू सी समबडी एल्स एंड अगेन एट टाइम्स यू फील एग्रेसिव दैट हैव यू गॉन टू समबडी एवर एंड से मुझे देख। अल्टीमेटली वी आर आल्सो ह्यूमंस, इजंट इट? राइट? बट दे ऑल ट्रीट यू एज आइडल्स, idols and love to give you gyan. One side. They will not ask you, beta, nobody will ask you, beta, you know, what are your skills, what are your qualities, based on which these qualities you should do what. They will come and throw something on you. So our consultants are number one friends. Ye to number one consultant hai, hai na? I always say the most useless people whom you can ever trust for your consultation are the people sitting next to you, known as friends. Because they are Greek, understand? You understand the word Greek? What do you mean by Greek? What is Greek? Poor. They are themselves very poor. Poor does not mean monetarily poor. Poor means mentally poor. They themselves don't know anything. But they will always come and talk big to you. And the moment they learn a new word, or school mein to bahut maza aata hai. If you know a new word, you go and tell your friends, which they don't know. It makes you feel so excited. Yes, no? So somebody comes to you and say, or you ask somebody, you know, what do you want to do? So he says, you know, I'm going to do paleontology. You know, paleontology? You don't know paleontology? Make you feel poverty struck. Yes, no? Or what we call below poverty line. Don't forget, not monetarily.
Mentally.
Right? I always tell children when they come with such confusions, don't listen to them because they themselves don't know. Usko bhi uska matlab nahi pata hai jo word bol raha hai. So relax. Huh? So our consultants are our friends. Which are the most useless people, I don't want to take them in consideration at all. But yes, I do want to take in consideration because sometimes other three people may make sense. Sometimes. But the most sense come from the people who are from the trade. When I say trade, I mean who are the people who are involved in education close to you? Who are the people? First set of people who are involved in education close to you are your teachers, right? So if a teacher is suggesting you something, I don't say believe it blindly. Give it a ear and think, why is my teacher saying this thing? Even when these people come and talk, ask them this question: why do you feel engineering is the best? Why do you feel medical is the best? Why do you feel I should go to aviation? Why do you think I should become a lawyer? Why do you think I should become a CA? And if they give you an answer, ki tu chup kar mujhe bata hai, main bata raha hu na, I hope all of you can understand that's an illogical argument. Yes, no? But if they tell you that these are your qualities, I observe these qualities in you, and these are the qualities which are required for that profession, so I feel you will do very good in that profession, then your brain can understand. Yes, no?
Yes.
Huh? So our consultants are all of them. They love to guide you even when nobody guided them. They love to display knowledge of all fields even when they studied only one field. And they love to give gyan even when they did not take gyan from anyone. Ek aur bahut common thought or word aapko sunne mein milta hai, hamare time pe aisa nahi tha. Yes, no?
Yes.
हम जो एडल्ट लोग हैं ना, हमको बड़ा मजा आता है इस तरह का ज्ञान में. हाँ, दूसरे वाले को बता के कि यू आर प्रिविलेज्ड, हमारे पास तो कुछ भी नहीं है. समझ रहे? उस पर ज्यादा टेंशन नहीं लेने का. गिव देम डिस्काउंट, डिस्काउंट ऑन व्हाट एवर दे आर सेइंग. है ना? कंफ्यूजन एट योर एज. What are the type of confusions which you encounter at your age? What do you want to do? Karna kya hai? Kya banna hai? What profession do you want to get into? Engineering is better or medicine? Commerce fits better or arts? And then you get a lot of suggestions. Do you understand that in our Indian education system, after grade 10, primarily there are only 4 streams. Are you aware of that? Conference is it? Can you tell me?
Science,
commerce,
arts,
arts or humanities to say one.
Commerce.
Commerce ho chuka. Diploma is a separate set of education. Diploma ke andar bhi aap inhi mein se kisi stream mein jaoge.
Biology
again is a subject of science.
Science.
जो चार स्ट्रीम्स हैं, उसमें से पहला स्ट्रीम है जिसको हम कहते हैं साइंस ए ग्रुप, विच मींस फिजिक्स, केमिस्ट्री एंड मैथमेटिक्स. दैट ग्रुप नोन एज साइंस ए ग्रुप इज ऑल्सो नोन एज द इंजीनियरिंग ग्रुप. है ना? सो साइंस ए ग्रुप इज रिक्वायर्ड इफ यू वांट टू गेट इनटू इंजीनियरिंग. Second group in science is known as science B group, which is known as physics, chemistry, biology. This group is also known as medical group, if you want to get into medicine area. Third stream is the commerce stream. Can you tell me the main subjects in commerce? Accounts, statistics, economics, and business studies. Right? And the fourth stream is humanities or arts. They are both same. And can you tell me what are the main subjects in humanities and arts?
Psychology,
literature comes in a part of English, which will be common to across four things. So it's psychology, history, 11th civics nahi aata. Civics 10th mein happy birthday aata. So it's normally psychology, history, geography, political science or sociology and philosophy. These are the areas which come in humanities or arts. Right? Now, very simple. How to choose what is right fit for me? So, uske liye pehla suggestion kya hai? Don't listen to everyone. Everyone means, aisa nahi main bol raha hu ki kisi ki baat mat suno. What I am saying is, when you get a lot of suggestions, try to question those suggestions. Because as I said, you're all young adults. You have own sane brains. I hope all of you have. Anybody who's in confusion? Sir, I don't have. I hope you all have brains. Yes, no?
Yes.
And working condition. Anybody who's left it somewhere? No, I know you can leave your heart somewhere. But I have never heard you can leave your brain somewhere. But still I want to check. All of you have it, your brain in your own possession?
Yes.
It is working?
Yes.
Ask yourself. Give yourself that question. Why is this person saying this thing to me? Does it really gel well with me as a person? For that, there are three things which we will try to figure out. First thing is known as your interest. You understand the word interest?
Yes.
Sunai, can you tell me what you mean by interest?
Jo humko pasand hai.
Anybody else?
Hobby.
Huh? Hobby type. Okay, hobby is an advanced level thing. You may not have a very strong hobby at this age. But yes, hobby type. But anybody who can explain it to a layman, yeah.
Something which satisfies you or gives you happiness.
Okay. You're close by. Anybody else?
Your passion.
Passion. Okay. To give you answer in a single line, something which when you start doing, you lose the track of time. वो करते समय आपको वक्त का पता ही नहीं चलता. That is your interest. You really enjoy doing it. It may be playing cricket, it may be playing guitar, it may be solving questions on mathematics, it may be doing science experiments, it may be reading history, it may be reading novels and books, it may be taking understanding of the current affairs, it may be reading about politics, it may be reading about Bollywood, Katrina. You know, Katrina, cat, you know, boys. For girls, it is, which one is the favorite one these days? Which one? Oh, Varun Dhawan. That's your interest area, right? And what gets you really excited in life, not just in school. So one thing which you will do, this exercise you will do after you go home today, you will write this word interest in your copy, write it down, interest. Write this word, just this word interest. And after going back home, you will write down all the things which you enjoy. It may be as stupid, which you may feel, as eating pizzas. When I start eating pizzas, I lose time. I lose the track of time. I enjoy. That's okay. Write it down. So write down and there will not be 1, 2, 3, 4 things. There will be 10, 15, 20 things which you really get excited with. Write all those things. Whatever comes to your mind, write down. That is your interest area. Is the interest clear?
Yes.
Everyone?
Yes.
Second thing which you need to be very careful about is understanding your aptitude. Have you heard this word?
Yes.
Aptitude?
Yes.
How many of you heard it? Kitna logon ne suna hai? Okay. Jinhone suna hai, can you tell me? Or can you tell a layman what does aptitude mean?
Things you are good at.
Things you are good at.
Somewhere where your skills and your interest meet.
Interest is different. Skill is different. Anybody else? Anybody who wants to contribute. What do you mean by the word aptitude? आपने सुना है many a times I get a lot of children who would come and say, sir, मुझे aptitude test देना है. सुना है? एप्टीट्यूड टेस्ट में पूछता हूँ क्यों देना है सर उससे मुझे पता लगेगा कि मेरे को क्या करना है हाउ
टेस्ट योर स्किल्स यू गेट टू नो वेरी गुड एट यू गेट टू नो वेरी गुड एट
यू गेट टू नो वेरी गुड एट लेट मी एक्सप्लेन इट टू यू आर वेरी क्लोज टू इट लेट मी एक्सप्लेन टू यू मोर आई वुड से एलैबोरेटली बचपन में कितने लोग छोटे थे नहीं, एक दो होंगे बीच में जो छोटे नहीं है, सभी थे। अरे वाह, वेरी गुड। रिमेंबर योर चाइल्डहुड, एंड इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू रिमेंबर योर चाइल्डहुड, यू मस्ट बी हैविंग अ यंगर ब्रदर सिस्टर एट होम, यू मस्ट हैव सीन हिम और हर ग्रोइंग, रिमेंबर दैट चाइल्ड। Even if you don't have a younger brother, sister, you must be seeing some chindus roaming around in the society. Igloo-igloos roaming around in the society. You will always see a specific two type of children. One set of children are children, jisko papa market se wo chuk-chuk train lake de. Chalne mati. You know, all of us have trained in that chuk-chuk train. So the train comes, he puts up the tracks, he puts the train on it. After inserting the batteries, and then he starts, and the train starts running on the track, chuk 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 chuk. But after a couple of rounds, he is not too much interested in continue running the train. He is more interested in ki papa kamre se bahar kab jayenge. Can you tell me why?
So that he can open.
So that he can break open the train and see how does it work. And when papa comes back into the room, he is holding a motor on a battery in his hand and say, see papa, train aise chalti thi. Train ka everybody over. Have you seen that children? And there is another set of children who are not interested in car, plane, train, helicopter, whatsoever. They are only interested in Mai aur Mera Mickey Mouse. They will sit in a corner, take a paper, draw a cartoon with a crayon, color it uselessly, and when papa comes from office, go to him and say, see papa, this is you. Have you seen such children?
Yes. Huh?
And there is another set of children who are not interested in any one of them. They are too much interested in knowing things. For anything and everything, they will go and ask Q. You tell them, beta, this is a chair. Bole Q. This is a fan. Bole Q. Right? This is a coat. Bole Q. One day papa comes from office and says, beta, I am your papa. He says, Q. Have you seen such children?
Yeah.
What is the difference between these three children?
Their interest, the way they look at things.
The first child has got mechanical aptitude. Second child has got creative aptitude. Third child has got argumentative aptitude. And when you grow and you become young adults, these aptitudes get converted in subject areas. So remember, in your class, there must be one child who always gets maximum marks in maths. I struggle so hard, still I am unable to get so many marks in maths. And there's another Didi who always tops in history. I don't understand history as a subject. Yes, no? Hota hai aisa? Sabki class mein hoga. You know what is the difference? For the child who is doing good in mathematics, mathematics comes naturally to him. What this girl said, what you are good at. And what you are good at is not defined by your skill. It is defined by what comes naturally to you. That child is able to understand maths quickly, with ease. So whatever that child is able to learn or get in 15 minutes, it may take me 1.5 hours. Right? And the best part is, at your age, aptitude can be enhanced. So whichever subject you are not feeling comfortable with, normally what do we do with that?
Struggle hard.
We ignore.
Run away.
We run away. History nahi aati, we always, whenever history comes, you start finding excuses. Mama! Whenever mama says, sit down and study history, mama! You know, you find out excuses. Don't do it. Your age is the best age to enhance your aptitude. You're being primarily exposed to 5 different aptitudes at present. You're being exposed to language aptitude in format of English, Hindi, Sanskrit, French, Gujarati. These are all language, linguistics. You are being exposed to mathematical aptitude by fundamental of maths. You are being exposed to science, primarily physics, chemistry and biology. You are being exposed to social sciences, which is your history, civics, geography, economics, and you are being exposed to another area which may be art and craft, physical education, computers. These are the five set of differential aptitudes which you are being exposed to. Whichever subject you feel uncomfortable with, give it head on. Put more time in that subject. You will be able to improve. Because as I said, at your age, aptitude can be enhanced. At my age, ma'am's age, or your teacher's age, our aptitude has gone fixed. If we are good at something, we are good. If we are not, we are not. It is very difficult to improve. It is possible, but difficult. But at your age, it is relatively easy. 2 months, if you spend on a subject seriously, which you are not comfortable with, you will see your scores will start going up like this. Stop running away. So second thing which we identified is aptitude. So below interest, write the word aptitude. And in that aptitude, write all the subjects which you feel comfortable with. Right? That is what you are naturally good in doing. And third is identify your personality. Have you heard this word personality? What do you understand by personality?
How
your
behavior towards others, how your image.
Behavior towards others. Why not behavior in absence of others? Is that not my personality? अगर मैं चुगली करता हूं बैक बाइटिंग दैट इज ऑल्सो माई पर्सनैलिटी
पर्सपेक्टिव
वॉट यू आर योर नेचर एटीट्यूड बिहेवियर द वे यू टॉक द वे यू वॉक The amount of confidence which you hold, your communication skills, your driving skills, they all form part of your personality. Now let me quickly understand or make you connect with where career, what is the connect of the career with personality? Let us say you have a stomachache, you go to the doctor, and the moment you enter the door of the doctor's clinic, the doctor shouts at you, "Hey! Again you come with your stomachache? So many times I have asked you not to eat out." And then without even questioning, asking, making you sit, he literally pushes you on that bed, takes out a thick injection and gives a tight one at your butt. And you're screaming. And there's another doctor whom you go to, he makes you sit. He feels your pulse. He asks you, "Beta, what happened? Where is it paining?" He touches your stomach. Then he asks you, "What did you eat yesterday?" And you very nicely tell him, "I ate pani puri." Then he tells you, "Beta, these days the season is changing, and you know you should not have pani puri. So I'm giving you a tablet. Eat it. You're having a stomach infection. If it gets eradicated in a day or so, it is great. Otherwise, I'll have to administer a injection to you." Which out of two doctors would you prefer to go? Both may be masters in medicine, both may have graduated from the same college, both may have been equally intelligent. Why you prefer to go to the second one? Because of his personality. He's humane, he's polite, and that is the personality you require for a doctor. If you have only option to go to the first doctor and next time you have a stomach ache, you tell your mother, "Leave it, it will get cured automatically. I won't go to that jallad." Yes, no? Whatever profession we wish to choose, each profession is linked with the personality. But at your age, it is too early to have to start grooming your personality, because each profession requires a different personality. But at least you should know what sort of a person you are. So third thing below aptitude, you write keyword personality. And you go to your friends, that is your best friend. Go to your cousins who you gel very well with. Go to your parents, go to your teachers. Ask them, can you give me one word which defines me? We do a small exercise. I've been interacting with you for almost last 25 minutes. Right? If your principal ma'am comes to you or Malik sir comes to you and asks, there was a gentleman who had come in the morning, how will you define that person in one word? What will you say? Can you define in one word what sort of a person this guy was?
Motivational.
Motivating, okay.
Friendly.
Convincing.
Encouraging.
What are all those things? All these things?
Personality.
They are adjectives which define your personality. Yes, no? So you will ask your close people, they will be able to tell you what do they think you are. Write down all those things. And based on these three things, you should choose whichever career you wish to go for. So the basic rules are identify your aptitude, personality and interest. Are they aligned to the career which you want to choose? And based on that, draw an action plan. Right? So these are the baseline to choose the right career. I'll quickly tell you the qualities which you require to go for Science A group, B group, Commerce and Arts, because these are primarily the four areas or options available in Indian education after 10th. Yes, no? So for Science A group, what combination of things you should be good at? You should be excellent at science, especially with physics and chemistry. And you should be excellent with mathematics. So if you are in grade 7 or 8 or 9 and you have a forethought that you want to get into Science A group, you should work super strong in the areas of physics, chemistry and mathematics. At 10th level, your mathematics should be 95% plus and your physics and chemistry has to be 90% plus. Along with that, when you are talking about Science A group, you require to cover a lot of volume of subject, that is the physics, chemistry, biology or physics, chemistry, mathematics. So you need to be spending long hours on study. Not that commerce requires less hours or arts require less hours. I am not saying that. But what I am saying is, science requires definitely more hours because the volume which you need to study is higher. So for next 2 years or 3 years or 1 year, you need to very strongly concentrate and work super strong and hard in mathematics and science. For Science B group, you need to be excellent at science, especially with the biology and physics. Now, a lot of children who are doing very good in biology, I have seen in grade 7, 8, 9, not doing that well in physics. Reason is, the bent of mind which you require for biology and physics is different. So your one bent of mind is good, other bent of mind is not that good. But as I said, at your age, you can improve your aptitude. You can improve your bent of mind. Work super hard in that. So work strongly on science, especially in biology and physics for next 1 to 3 years. If you want to go for commerce, your mathematical skills have to be very good and your economics has to be very good. So what you need to do is, you need to be good at mathematics and economics. So work strongly on maths and have curiosity towards business. Your brain should continuously think about profit, loss, discount, where do I get a better deal, how do I get a better deal. That's a type of mental model which you need to have. For Science A group, what type of mental model you should have? You should be connected more to technology. You need to be connected more to technology. You should know about the latest things happening. You should be more comfortable with operating on machines. For Science B group, you should be more comfortable with life sciences, playing with pets, playing with worms, playing with birds, you know, which is more towards life sciences. Next, for humanities, you should be good at subjects which are language and social sciences. That is English, history, civics, geography, and so on. So for next 2 to 3 years, work very strongly on social sciences and English. By and large, I keep telling children in the school that when you are in grade 7, 8, 9, actually speaking, you should be working on all subjects very hard, bringing them up to 90, 95, 100 percentile or CGPA level. Reason being, this is your base. After 10th, if you leave history, it is not going to make a difference. But if you have done history very well till 10th and you are doing engineering, even somewhere in engineering, history will play its role. Let me give you an example. Have you heard about a college known as IISE, Indian Institute of Sciences in Bangalore?
Yes.
It is supposed to be the best sciences institute in Asia and ranks in the top rankings in the world. You know, IISE is the first institute to have started teaching social sciences subject along with engineering and sciences. So if you are studying physics there, you are definitely supposed to study sociology. You're definitely supposed to study history. So the entire education system in the world is moving towards cross-functional subject understanding, which is there in our education system in the school, but not there in higher education. So what I'm trying to motivate you on is, if you study all subjects very well in school, when you go into higher education, you will face less problems. But if you are not getting mathematics, for example, very well in school, so you ignore, and you just pass with 35 marks in mathematics in grade 10, it may not be a very good idea. Because somewhere down the line, if you even want to do PhD in English, you know the entrance exam of PhD would require you to give answer to questions in mathematics. So that time you will struggle. That time you will remember ki yaar maine 10th mein maths thoda kiya hota to it would have been better. So it is time for you to spend lot of time in cross board subjects, whether it is maths, whether it is pure sciences, whether it is social sciences, whether it is languages, and or whether it is other subjects related to art, craft, music, dance, acting, sports, mimicry, and so on. Spend a lot of time. Finally, if you are feeling that I am not very sure about Science A group, B group, Commerce, Arts, I want to tell you, don't worry. In 11th, 12th, once you've taken any one of these, there are a lot of degree courses which are available to everyone. So the degree courses which you can go beyond, even from science, you can go to law. Even from humanities, you can go to hotel management. Even from biology, you can go to business management. From commerce, you can go to mass communication. So anyone, all these degree options are available to everybody. So don't think that what perspective or what option you will choose post grade 12. I always tell children, at every point of time, you should be clear about next 2 years. And for you, the clarity which I want to give you for next 2 years is, study hard across subjects. After 10th, we will take the first call, and after 12th, we will take the next call. Why I am sharing this with you is, a lot of people will come to you and say, nahi nahi, maths nahi karoge to climb band ho jayengi, physics nahi karoge to kuch kar nahi paoge, history nahi padoge to kuch problem ho jayega. Kuch problem nahi hoga. You should study all these subjects, and all these subjects are open to everybody after 12th. That may be in the area of law, hotel management, business management, mass communication, liberal studies, computer applications, design, social sciences, armed forces, and so on and so forth. My last piece of advice to all of you, never blindly follow friends. Unki baat to bata di maine. Sabse useless character hote hain log. And also don't follow trends. Because a lot of parents would come to me and say, sir, aajkal sabse happening career kaun sa hai? Main kehta hu ki Bollywood. नहीं नहीं सर मतलब कोई ऐसा करियर बताओ जिसमें बहुत सारे पैसे हो तो मैं बोलता हूँ कि भोपाल में पाव भाजी की लारी लगा बहुत पैसे That's a wrong thing. You can never find a career and fit yourself. You can always understand yourself and based on that choose the right career. Right? Thank you very much.